Of course, it wasn't in any way cool, but the tenuous excuse I have is that this was 1975. By the time I left college, the red packet had been replaced by a desert scene, and Camel became my brand until I finally stopped in 1999. It was so freeing being away from home like this. I was suddenly in an environment with more freedom and opportunities than I had ever had before. I was in a college with like-minded people, people whose central motivation was music and people who were hugely talented. It was a real nirvana for me. In my second week, Campbell told me that there was a party on the Saturday evening and that we had been invited. There was a rather lovely second-year singer who I had noticed around and about, and I plucked up courage to ask her to the party. To my utter astonishment, she said yes. I had already mentioned to the patients that I had been invited to a party, and it was in Clapham, and that I may not make it home to Kingston, so all was well there. It was just as well I did, because when I met her at Bond Street Tube that evening, she was wearing a rather special Laura Ashley flowery black velvet dress with a slit up the side, and it was very obvious that she was wearing the full works underneath. Goodness me, let's say that my induction to college life was completed that night. In the morning, she was singing in the professional eight-piece choir in St. George's, Hanover Square, so I bowled along with her before making my way back to Kingston, and for a few weeks we were quite the item. She shared a little first-floor flat in northwest London, so we sometimes continued our liaisons there, and sometimes even in one of the rehearsal rooms in Dynelly's. Then the bombshell. She told me that the guy she was going to marry was turning up, so we would have to call things off for a bit. I was devastated. I had no idea she was engaged, and I certainly wasn't going to be just a pleasant diversion for her. So we parted ways.